Now, the one more problem. For any two vectors a bar and b bar, we always have a dot b less than or equal to mod a mod b. Any two vectors a bar and b bar. So, this inequality always hold a dot b less than or equal to mod a mod b, known as Cauchy-Schwarz inequality. Now, let us prove. We have a bar dot b bar is equal to mod a mod b cos theta by the definition of the dot product. But the cos theta is always less than or equal to 1. Cos theta is always less than or equal to 1. Therefore, this product must be less than or equal to mod a into mod b. Mod a into mod b into some cos theta value less than or equal to 1. So that the maximum value of this entire product is mod a mod b. Therefore, finally, a bar dot b bar is always less than or equal to mod a mod b. Modulus of a vector, modulus of b vector. Now, this is the first inequality known as Cauchy-Schwarz inequality. Next one, ninth one. For any two vectors a bar and b bar, we always have modulus of a plus b less than or equal to mod a plus mod b. Modulus of a plus b less than or equal to mod a plus mod b, known as triangle inequality. Now, let us take two vectors. A b bar is a bar and b c bar is equal to b bar. Now, AC bar will be A bar plus B bar by law of triangle, addition law. Let us take AB bar is equal to, AB bar is equal to A bar and BC bar is equal to B bar. Then AC bar is equal to A plus B. Now, we shall consider modulus of a plus b whole square. Modulus of a plus b whole square is equal to modulus of a plus b dot a plus b. Now, by distributive property, it is mod a square a dot a plus a dot b plus b dot a, same as 2 a dot b. Hence, it is 2 times of a dot b plus b dot b is equal to mod b square. Now, which is modulus of a square plus 2 times of, you know, a dot b again is mod a mod b cos theta. We can write a dot b as mod a mod b cos theta plus mod b square. But here the maximum value of cos is 1. Hence, this total summation should be less than or equal to mod a square plus 2 into mod a mod b plus b square. Since the maximum value of cos, this entire summation would be less than or equal to mod a square plus 2 into mod a mod b plus mod b square. You know, this is the expansion of mod a plus mod b whole square. So, finally, this implies that, so modulus of a plus b whole square less than or equal to mod a plus mod b whole square. This implies that modulus of a plus b is less than or equal to mod a plus mod b. Hence, the second inequality also hold, known as triangle inequality. We have the triangle inequality as mod a plus b less than or equal to mod a plus mod b.
So just now we proved that.
When does the equality holds? Now let us see. Here AB is one vector A bar and BC is another vector B bar and AC is the vector is sum of AB and BC, that is A plus B. Now let us see, when does the equality holds? Modulus of A plus B is equal to mod A plus mod B. When does it happens? You know, modulus of A plus B. A plus B vector is AC vector. The modulus of A plus B is mod AC is equal to mod A is equal to mod AB vector, modulus of AB vector, mod B is equal to modulus of BC vector. The sum of AB and BC is equal to AC. It happens if and only if ABC are collinear. If the three points ABC are collinear, then only this equality holds. AB plus BC become AC. So this condition is possible when the three points are collinear. So that in triangle inequality, equality holds when the given points are collinear. If they are non-collinear, then inequality holds. Now, here one problem, 10th problem here. Show that the points A, minus 2i plus 3j plus 5k, B, I plus 2j plus 3k and C, 7i minus k are collinear. So, three points are given. Now, we have to prove that the three points are collinear. So, we can use this equality condition to prove the three points are collinear. Now, given the position vector of A, I mean OA bar is equal to minus 2i plus 3j plus 5k. So, the point is nothing but position vector of the corresponding point A. And from this, the point A is minus 2 comma 3 comma 5. Next, position vector of B, OB bar, is given that I plus 2j plus 3k. From this, B point is 1, 2, 3. The position vector of C, I mean OC, given that 7i minus k, this implies that the point C is 7 comma 0 comma minus 1. Now, let us find the distances AB, BC and AC. AB vector is equal to OB minus OA vector. AB vector is equal to OB minus OA. OB minus OA is equal to I minus of minus 2i plus 3i, 2j minus 3j minus j, 3k minus 5k minus 2k. Next, BC vector is equal to OC minus OB, 7i minus i, 6i minus 2j minus k minus 3k minus 4k. And AC vector is equal to OC minus OA, 7i plus 2i, 9i minus 3j minus k minus 5k minus 6k. Now the three vectors AB, BC, AC are defined. Now let us find the magnitudes of the three vectors. The modulus of AB vector is equal to root over 9 plus 1 plus 4, 3 square plus minus 1 whole square plus minus 2 whole square, 9 plus 1 plus 4, that is root 14. Modulus of BC vector is equal to, what is the magnitude of BC vector? It is 6 square 36 plus minus 2 whole square 4 plus minus 4 whole square 16. It is 20 plus 36, 56, root 56. You know, root 56 is equal to 4 14s. Root of 4 into 4, root of 4 into 14 is equal to 2 root 14. Next, the magnitude of AC vector, that is root of 9 square, 81 plus minus 3 whole square, 9 plus minus 6 whole square, 36. What about this? 81 plus 9, 90, 90 plus 36, 126. You know, 126 is 14 nines, 14 into 9. That means square root of 14 into 9 is equal to 3 root 14. Here, sum of two distances or sum of two magnitudes is equal to magnitude of the third vector. So, clearly it is observed that AC plus, AB, magnitude of AB plus BC is equal to root 14 plus 2 root 14 is equal to 3 root 14, which is equals to magnitude of AC. Therefore, sum of two magnitudes is equal to magnitude of third vector. Hence, ABC are collinear. Therefore, finally, the given points are collinear.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.